Welcome in, or welcome back. First, I need to get some legalities out of the way. The following video contains that of my own personal experience and my own opinions. I dare you to fact check it. Anyway, today it's about the Honourable Shannon Fentiman MP, who is the Minister for Health, Mental Health and Ambulance Service, and also the Minister for Women. I presented to my local emergency department a little while ago. It's going through the list of my symptoms, right? As you do. I was struggling to breathe, which isn't, you know, unheard of for me lately. Apparently it happens all the time now. But this was different. I also had back pain. They rushed me through. Surprise, surprise. I had back pain. I was just not feeling the greatest. I have pictures. If I can work out how to put them in here, I will. So, they wheeled me back. I could walk, but they wheeled me back. Took my blood pressure. Oh, your blood pressure's a bit low. Yeah, no, always is. So that was fine. You're put in a bed. I told them I have Ramsay Hunt syndrome. No one knew what I was talking about, except the doctor. Which is fine, because I had no idea either. It's actually when you get shingles in your ear. It's kind of gross. Actually, it's really gross, and it hurts really bad. So they put me in a gown. They test my heart. Heart's fine. Could have told you that. Heart's fine. I get 3 rounds of blood taken. They test it all. Yep, cool. I turned around and I said, I've just started antivirals. I think I'm allergic to them. Don't be silly. No one's allergic to antivirals. I am an enigma. I am sorry. I'm actually allergic to antivirals, or at least the ones I had. So they made me take one. With an antihistamine, because I was under their care and apparently had to do what I was told. I don't like doing that. So I did. I got worse. Even the nurse said, because I had 2 pictures to compare it. She's like, you actually look worse now than the last picture. Cool. Love it. So that was fine. Then I got admitted to short stay. Yep, short stay. 1 o'clock I was woken up. Mind you, I'd been there since about 4. 1 o'clock I was woken up. Your heart's fine, you can go home. I still hurt. I am still so much pain. And I'll tell you now, I can deal with a lot of pain, but this I could not. That's how bad it was. My back is broken. I can deal with that. Not this. So that's fine. Went home. As soon as I woke up, I called my doctor. I need to see him now. We don't have any available times. Yep, cool. I haven't peed in 18 hours. I need to see him now. Oh, we should probably go to the hospital. Oh, going back up there again. She's like, oh, come in when you can. Cool, so I went in. He couldn't touch me. I'm used to being poked and prodded. The pain was that bad. He couldn't touch me. He He read the letter from the hospital, my discharge letter. I got discharged with gastroenteritis. No, it wasn't actually. The last antiviral I had was in the hospital. This next picture was only after two antibiotics. My kidneys were failing. They weren't working. But your main priority was to check my heart. Cool. Go for worst case scenario, because we all know vax injuries lead to heart issues. Not me. It's everything else that's broken. So he's kind of pissed at that. Won't lie, he was a bit pissed. He turned around and stated, we need to keep you out of there. Out of where? Out of the hospital. Okay. Got no issues from me. It's not the first time I've had issues with a hospital. Probably won't be the last. But those closest to me know that I will die at home before they're allowed to take me up there. I won't do it. Not after that last time. So, Shannon Fentiman. Even though, yes, you wanted to fight Miles for the premier position, fix your own damn backyard before you take on anything else. You need to prove yourself in your position instead of taking happy snaps with patients and thinking everything's okay. You have a massive problem on your hands. And it's not just that hospital. Queensland wide, guaranteed. Fix your own backyard. And I'm not finished. Next time, the real pandemic, scabies. And how much mold is too much mold for an emergency waiting room? Both with pictures. Stay tuned. Much love.